One of the most exciting things that you can do with Dynamics 365 real-time marketing is work with Power Automate to go beyond the concept of what you would normally do with a marketing journey. So normally we start in a marketing journey, we start with a segment, we go through and send out marketing email communications, SMSs, branching logic, and so on. Power Automate allows us to do trigger and action automations, workflows. So something happens, then post some data to another system or send a notification to someone. And we can bring these things together so that now your marketing journey can be bigger than just marketing. Think about orchestrating a journey across the whole organization here. So something comes through and you've done some email communication, and out of a certain action path in your marketing journey, you want someone to take a follow-up action or you want to post data to another system. You can totally do that. Let me show you how. My example here that I'm working with is a nonprofit organization that is receiving donations into Dynamics 365. That comes through in the form of a transaction. Now, this will work regardless of your scenario. If you're doing something where you might have a major purchase coming in, it's exactly the same concept. And the journey that I've got here is a really nice, simple one. Think of this as just a little snippet of a journey. You can have a whole lot else going on around it, but I'm just showing you this specific piece for what I want to do here with the custom action. Also, do not be afraid of the word custom. There is no code here. I don't do code. This is all drag and drop and click and point stuff. So we start with this trigger. That donation has come in, that transaction has been created inside Dynamics. And then we're looking at an attribute of that particular transaction that came in, and we're saying, was it over a certain value? There's a test in there to say, was that over $5,000? If yes, it's going down that yes path, and we are activating a custom trigger to create a task. What that does is creates a task like this. So we've got a person here, and the task is sitting in there with all of that information coming through from the trigger. So when we're working this way, we've got a bunch of information being fed into the journey, and we can use that to output at the end with this task. So it knows who the person is, the value of the donation, and the date of the donation. So there are a few components we need to put together here. The first thing is that we need to create a custom trigger, which is going to be the eventual sort of output. So the thing we want to do here is to create a follow-up task. I'm going to go into the triggers section here in real-time marketing. We're going to create a new trigger, give it a name, make it something that's going to be really easy to find when you're working in your journey so you know which one it is. And we've got two options here. I'm actually going to create this one because this allows me to set up a custom trigger where I can choose what the inputs are going to be. So I want full control over that. This one is something else for another time. So let's click create. You can add a description here to further describe what it is. And then all we need to do here is set up the attributes. So what information are we working with in this trigger? Now, even though we're using this to create a task, the actual task creation part is going to be done by Power Automate, and it will take care of putting in the subject and the description and the due date and all of those things. So what we're doing here, we're creating a piece here that is taking us from what's coming through in the journey that we want to collect to pass that through to that flow in Power Automate. So in this case, because we want to be able to pass through information about who the person is, who made the donation, the amount of the donation, and the date of the donation, those are the things we want to pass through as attributes. So what we're going to do here is just very simple, create an attribute. So the first thing we're going to put in is the donor, and that's just going to be a piece of text. We are going to put in the donation amount, and that is going to be a number. So you can see these are the options we've got. And we're also going to put in a donation date. That one is a date or time. That's it. Next. What we're doing here then is going through a process of setting this up, but we don't need to do any of this stuff with the code snippet. So the idea is here, you can use this to create code snippets. I could put this on my website, for instance, and if someone came and made a donation via a website, it would pick that up. But we're doing all of this inside Dynamics, so we don't need to do that part. So we go, thanks very much, just click next and click ready to use. And by the magic of video editing, this takes about 2 or 3 minutes in real life. I'm going to pause and come back and show you what happens. All right, there we go. Once it's done, you'll get this. You'll see that it's ready to use. Pending integration, we're not actually going to do that part because we're going to use it in a different way. and we're good to go. Now, I want this journey to actually be triggered as well based on that transaction coming into the system. Traditionally, we would start a marketing journey with a segment, grabbing a bunch of people who are alike. But if we start a journey with a trigger, then all of that information comes through into the journey to allow us to push it through to that task. But it also means that this is this whole concept of real-time marketing. Someone makes that donation and in real time, then it puts that person into the journey and does all of those things. So what we can do when we're working on something with Dataverse, triggers in Dataverse, this is really easy. Again, no code. We can come in here and say this is going to be a new transaction created. And this time I'm going to choose this first one, which is something related to a customer in the system. So we'll click create there. This is the easiest thing. I love this so much. New transaction, you didn't really spell that correctly. New transaction created. In which table is this happening? So we're going to go in and say it's in the transaction table. So we just find that in there. Whatever you're working with here, if this is anything else in the system, you can work with this, including custom tables, by the way. And then it's who is the audience, like who's the person? Because obviously when you're sending out an email or sending out, you know, some kind of action in your journey, it needs to be connected to a person in the system. So it's saying which part of that table contains the audience. I know that it's called donor. That's where it is. That's the lookup to a customer in the system. And then do we want to activate this trigger based on a new record being created, an existing one, updated, or any of the above? And for me, this is going to be a new record being created. And then we go ahead and click ready to use. I'm not going to do that because I've already got this set up in the system from before. So I'm going to quit out of this, but I just wanted to show you how it's created. So now I'm going to navigate over here and click on journeys. I'm just going to discard that. You, of course, will have said ready to go. I'm going to go in here and create a new journey. And I'm going to use that trigger that we just created. Instead of starting it as a segment of a group of like people, we're going to use that trigger of that donation coming in. So we'll call this journey major donor follower. And I'm going to choose the trigger. This is one that I've created earlier, exactly the same as what I just showed you, which is transaction created, and we are good to go. From here, I've got my option to bring in all of the traditional marketing things. So somebody's made a donation, I would likely send them an email or send them a text message and do all those kinds of things. I'm not going to show you that here because I really want to focus on the idea of the trigger, but you would absolutely do all of that in there. So what I'm going to do here is, first thing I'm going to do is branch based on the value of that transaction, because starting with the transaction coming in now means the journey is aware of that information and we can use it in this way. So what we can do here is go in and check for a condition, and we're going to choose the attribute that goes with that. Now we've got options in here, and you'll see this as we go through. We can work with both the audience, the person, because it knows when this came in. Remember when we created that trigger, we had to say which is the contact person associated with it. So we've got that, but we've also got all the information about the trigger in here. So here we go. Here's the transaction was created, and I want to do a test on how much it was. So I'm going to say the amount is greater than or equal to, let's say $5,000 is our threshold for going through a call. Let's give it a more sensible name. Branch one is not very helpful. So we're going to say donation over $5,000 in there. And you can see that changing in there. At this point, let's save that. So we've got the transactions come in. If it's over $5,000, we're going to activate a custom trigger. So this is now picking up on that trigger we created earlier. So we're going to look for that. And it's the one here that is called create a follow-up task. Now, the whole purpose of this is just to knit these two things together between the customer journey and the Power Automate flow that we're going to create. And here are the attributes that we set up when we set up that trigger. Don't worry about the red exclamation marks. That's just warning me that I need to fill in all of these for this whole thing to be valid. But no problem at all. So donation amount, let's map the attribute in here. So this attribute, again, same thing we just saw, can come from either the audience or from that trigger. So the donation amount is coming from the trigger, from the transaction. So we're going to go in here, click through, and say that is the amount. Bingo. And we should have one green tick. There we go. Donation date, same concept. That is also coming from the transaction, and that is the book date. That's done too. The donor, however, is not from the transaction. The donor is from the audience, the person who's entered this journey. So what we'll do here is we can bring in any attribute we want. We're going to go from the audience. But to make it a little bit easier on us as we go into the flow, I'm going to bring the person's full name. If you've got a long list of things in here, then you can just start typing it in. So we're going to bring the full name of the person in there, first name, last name, and that's it. Okay, green ticks all the way. Happy times. Let's save that again. And then what we're going to do is create the flow that goes with that and picks up on that trigger. So switch across here into my solution, either inside Flow or inside Power Apps. We're going to go and create a new automation, Cloud Flow, automated Cloud Flow. This is just something you need to know. It's a couple of things you just need to know. There's one piece here, which is the piece that connects these things together. So we'll call this a major donor follow-up task flow. And then we're going to search for the trigger, which is using Dataverse. So Dataverse is the database that's sitting underneath all of Dynamics 365. And the thing that we need to do to bring these things together is use this one here, which is called when an action is performed. So when an action is performed is aware of lots of different actions in the system, including actions that are triggered by the real-time marketing journey. So now we go ahead and create the flow. Let me just zoom this up a little bit to make it a bit clearer. And there are some options here that honestly you just need to remember they're always going to be the same. So catalog, we're going to choose CXP. Category, we will choose custom. Table name is none. And then the action name, this is where you choose that trigger that you picked earlier, which in this case is that create a follow-up task. So just remember those things. Those are the things you're going to use every time when you're doing this piece of connecting that journey to a Power Automate flow using the when an action is performed step. So from here, we go ahead and create whatever it is we want to do in the flow. We've connected those pieces now. So we use the new step option. And what we're going to do here is create a task inside Microsoft Dataverse. So you can see there's the connection. That's going to create a task in Dynamics that also flows through to Outlook and To-Do. It's all the same object, which is cool. But you can use any connector here. It doesn't have to be pushing something back into Dynamics. You could create a Teams option or an Outlook, whatever it is you want to do in here. So we create the new task. So we go ahead and just put in that table name, which is task, find it in the list in there, and then give it a second. That will come up with all of the different options there. So those are all of the different attributes we have for a task. We're going to put the subject in first, and you'll see as soon as I click on that, I'm getting this dynamic content. And hopefully you'll see at the top here, look at these things. This is what we created earlier. Donation amount, donation date, donor. Those are all of those attributes we created in the custom trigger. And so those are now available for us to use along with the profile ID, which is the name of the person, the donor contact connected to that. And we can use all of these things now, you know, when it comes through from that journey, it's pushing that dynamic content through. So we can say we've got a new donation from, and then choose donor. And remember in the journey, I mapped donor to full name. So now what this is going to do is to create that task with the person's full name in the subject. Now, we want to put a due date in here. It's a couple of extra steps that we're going to go through here just to sort out the date, because all of the dates in Flow are in universal coordinated time and also come in a format that's like 20.22.09.14 or whatever, which is not sort of very easily readable. So we can do a little bit better than that. So if we go in here and choose the time option, these are some standard things inside Power Automate. We're going to choose this one here called Convert Time Zone. And the first thing we need to define is what is the base time? What is the time piece that's coming into this from that marketing journey, which is actually the date of the donation. So that is our starting point there for the base time. So we click on that. We can see that dynamic content there again. And I'm going to go ahead and choose that piece of time that came in, which is the donation date that we mapped from the journey. From here, we go through and just fill out these other options. So the source time zone we're going to choose is coming from UTC here when it comes through into Flow. So we just choose that. Time zone to convert to, we want this to be in the time zone that I'm in here, which is Canberra, Melbourne, Sydney. Obviously choose your own one. And then we can choose the format for that time and date. So you see there's lots of different options in there. I'm going to enter a custom value because in my part of the world, we like to do dates in the following format, which is day, day, month, month. Note the capital M's there if you want this to work. And the four characters for the year. So that's all good. Now, one more step. Let's say we want to make this something where the due date is actually in the future. So we don't want the task to have a current due date. We want the task to be at some point in the future. So there's another cool little operator in here, which is called future date. So we just go in and find that, get future time. And then we can specify whatever interval we want here. So we can say this is going to be 2 weeks ahead or 2 months ahead or whatever it is. Now, if you wanted to change this at any point, if you wanted to come back and say, actually, we want that task to be due in 1 week or 1 month or whatever, you don't need to change anything else in the journey. You could actually just come and edit this flow and all of that other marketing journey stuff will be the same. Same if you wanted to send off another notification or whatever, you can always come back and edit that flow to change what's going in here. No problem at all. So now that we've got that set up, we can come in and specify the due date, and the due date we're going to pull from that component there that we just created called future time. And then I'm going to put some more information in the description here, which is sort of giving more information about, you know, where it came from and what the amount is, because we've brought all of that in. So you'll see the more things we bring into that trigger, the more we've got to play with in terms of the output. So just showing you can do that, popped a dollar sign in front of it because it just comes through as a number, not a currency. Save all of that, make sure that we're on track. And then there is one last step that we want to do here, which is to connect this up to the contact in the system. So when we saw it earlier in the timeline, we've got that set so that it's a special field in here called regarding, which links it up to the person. We just scroll down in here and we'll find the correct regarding. You can see you can link this up to lots of different things in the system, but in this case we want it to be a contact. And again, we can get the dynamic content in there. The way this works is that you need to type in the type or the plural name of the table, which is contacts, open bracket, and then we're going to choose from the list here that profile ID. That's that unique ID that comes with the person. Again, this is just one of these things that you can just copy from here that you need to remember in the way that these regarding fields are put together. Save that, and we are good to go. Let's go back and give this whole thing a burl now. Publish our journey, obviously. Do we make that live? That will take a couple of minutes to come through, and then I'll go ahead and create a transaction so that we can give this thing a test. I've skipped ahead. This takes a couple of minutes for your journey to go live, but you will see it there with published, and then you're good to go. I've got a fairly basic transaction creation experience here, all of these things in, but the core things to know, we've got the date and the amount, which is definitely over $5,000, and we've got a link to that same donor. So we're going to save and close that. So step away for a few minutes, let the whole thing process, and you can see here in the flow that we've got success. Very good. If you've got any problems, you'll get a failure message there. Let's go and have a look at the journey and give this a refresh. You'll likely see it come through in the flow before the journey. Just the journey flow takes a little while longer to show up on the screen, but it has actually gone through. So we can see there's the one that's gone through and followed that path. And let's go have a look at our contact here, Andrea. There she is. And there's the task that we've just created. Isn't that cool? Tell me what else you think you could use triggers for. This just opens up so many other possibilities. Pop your ideas in the comments and we'll see where we get. In the meantime, check out this other video and thank you very much for watching.